Hello everyone. Today we'll learn how to collect information, organize it, and even solve some fun puzzles. Data handling involves collecting data or information by observing a given picture, sorting, classifying, and organizing it, and then presenting it in a tabular form for better understanding. Puzzles are fun and engaging challenges that help sharpen the mind. So without any further delay, let's get started. Here is a farm scene. You have to sort the animals and items into groups. I shall tell you which all animals you have to sort: cows, chickens, sheep, pigs, ducks. And there are many more things over here, but we'll make a table out of this. As we said in data handling, we have to sort first, so we are doing sorting. How many of each type of animal are on the farm? So first of all, you have to draw a table, because when we present it in a tabular form. In one column, we'll write the name of the animals, and the other column, we'll write number of animals. So first, we'll take cows. You have to count the cows. Here I shall circle it. See how many cows are there? Two. So you will write here two. Next, chickens. You can see here how many chickens are there. I'll circle them and then you will write here four. Next, sheep. How many sheep are there? Two. Next, pigs. You can see here two pigs. Next, ducks. Duck, only one duck is there. So the total number of animals is 2 plus 4 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1, which is equal to 11. Now you will be asked some questions based on this data. But here I am going to just tell you chickens are maximum and ducks are least. Here is another question on sorting animals. Count the lions, elephants, zebras, monkeys and giraffes from the zoo scene. As before, you can draw a table like this, but here in this particular table, there is one column, extra column. What is it for? That is for tally marks. And what are tally marks? You have learned that in your 2D shape hunt and 3D shape hunt. The story of tally marks also is given in 2D shape hunt. You can watch the video. The link is in the description below. In the first column, you write name of animals, then tally marks, and then number of animals. So let us start counting lions. You can see I am putting here tick marks. So you can count the lions, and there are five lions. So this is how you put the tally marks. And in the third column, you write the number. Next animal, giraffes. These are the giraffes, and there are seven giraffes. And you will write the number here. Third, we are taking monkeys. There are four monkeys here and you'll write the number four. Next, elephants. Elephants you can count because they are very big in shape here, very clearly given. So I'm not putting tick marks. So there are six elephants. And the last we can take zebras. Zebras are three in number. And so the total animals are 5 plus 7 plus 4 plus 6 plus 3, which is equal to 25. Here, giraffes are maximum and zebras are least. Make a list of other animals and birds you see in the zoo scene. Count each type and write in a tabular form using tally marks. There are many more birds here. Trees are there. You can make your own table and practice doing more questions like this. This is a different type of question. Write the number of letters in the following names of the vegetables and answer the questions that follow. This is from the Mathematics Workbook. You can try to answer this. First is cabbage. And how many letters are there in cabbage? You have to count. There are seven letters. Next is broccoli, capsicum, carrot, cauliflower, melon. You count the letters of each and write them over here. And answer the questions. Which vegetable name has maximum number of letters? Which vegetable name has minimum number of letters? Which vegetable name has five letters? Melon has 5 letters. How many more letters are there in cauliflower than capsicum? So you have to subtract. Here there are some riddles. You can answer these. I am an odd number. Take away one letter and I become even. What number am I? 7. If you remove S, it becomes even. Next question. What has hands but can't clap? A clock. I am tall when I am young and short when I am old. What am I? Any idea? A candle. I am a 2-digit number. The sum of my digits is 12 and their difference is 6. What number am I? 93. 9 plus 3 is 12, 9 minus 3 is 6. I can be turned upside down and I will still look the same. What am I? 8. I am a 2-digit number as shown by the beads. What number am I? In tens place there is 1 bead and in ones place there are 2 beads. So the number is 12. I have 4 equal sides and 4 corners. What am I? A square. I am 1 less than 1. So, what am I? 0. I am the largest single digit number. What am I? 9. And the last one, I have 5 sides and 5 corners. What am I? Pentagon. Next type of question, shape sorting question. Here are some shapes. Circle, square, triangle and rectangle. Can you sort these shapes into groups? How many each shape do you see here? The answer is group of the shapes is you have to sort out circle 2, square 2, triangles 2, rectangles 1. And you have to write the count the way it is written here. Great job everyone! You have learned how to handle data and solve riddle puzzles. Remember, math is all about practice and having fun with numbers. Keep exploring, keep solving, and most importantly, keep enjoying your math voyage. This is my final video for grade 1. Stay tuned for the grade 1 New Year finale. Subscribe to my channel to know when I post my next video for grade 2 and 7th grade upwards. Wishing you all a very happy new year. Bye. Take care.